Hey guys, what's up? My name is Beatbreaker, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a sick transition for your live streams. Now, this is going to work regardless if you're using OBS Studio or Streamlabs OBS. Let's check it out. Now, to start off, you can either download the template that I've put in the description below, or you can create a new composition, use the height and width of your streaming canvas, as well as the refresh rate at which you're streaming. I, for example, am streaming at 2K resolution and 60 FPS, and select a duration of around 4 seconds. Now, for the sake of this video, I've created this very nice sample text that is kind of warping in with kind of this floor texture here. In case you're interested how I actually managed to do this effect here, then you can check out the tutorial by Video Copilot, who did this very nice tutorial on doing such a warping text effect in the top right hand corner right now. And it's really way too complicated to go through all of the steps required to create this effect here. But if you simply want to change this to display your name or your logo, then you can just go ahead and download the After Effects template in the description below. You can then go to the text composition and change the text, or you could even put a logo of yours in here. So you could really have whatever kind of effect shown as a transition. In my case, I'm just going to show this video here, but you could also just go with a still image, or you could even go with an actual video. Now, before I start with the actual transition effect, I'd like to mention that this transition has been inspired very heavily by a friend of mine, The Jumping Flame, who has a super cool transition in his Twitch streams. And once I saw that, I knew I have to create one of these on my own and do a video on it, because I think not enough people actually use such a cool transition yet. So if you want to check out his live streams, then I've left a link to his account in the description below. But now let's create our actual transition effect. For that, you want to head over to the main composition, and you can see I have the Stinger 2 composition in my main composition in here. And now what we want to do is we want to do a few masks to create our individual transition effect. Now you want to select the Stinger layer, hit the pencil icon, and now create a mask in a rectangular fashion. And to do this, I'm going to hold down Shift on my keyboard, and I'm going to create a very nice rectangular mask. I've kind of messed this one up a little bit, so I'm going to push it to the left a little bit while holding Shift. Now we want to duplicate this mask, so select the mask and hit Ctrl D and move the second mask up. Now, in order to align these two masks, what you want to do is you want to go to Shape of the first mask and copy the upper extension and paste this into the lower extension of the second mask. Now, if you simply duplicate these masks, obviously what you're going to end up with are simply masks of equal height. But really, for a good transition, what you want to do is you want to have different heights for each individual mask. So in order to do that, select the upper value of your second mask and change it around. And repeat this process until you have filled up your entire screen. Alright, so once you've filled up your entire frame with masks of differing heights, it's time to start with the animation. Now, at the time step where your transition should be finished, you want to add the stopwatches for the mask path. Do this for all masks, then go to the beginning of the scene and add more keyframes. Now, depending if you want to have your image being transitioned from the left or the right, you can now change the shape parameter left or right at the beginning. So for example, if you want to have it being transitioned from left to right, you can change your right extension to something like minus 200. And if you now go forward in time, you can see that the mask will reveal your image from left to right. Now we're going to do this for each of these individual keyframes and actually go a bit crazy here. So do different extensions here, maybe some 0, maybe some minus 350, and this just gives it a little bit more of a randomness to it. Run it, and as you can see, we already have kind of a nice transition. Now, this is obviously all way too closely packed, and you want to have a lot more randomness in this transition effect. So what you want to do is you want to just kind of go ahead and change these keyframes around. Be a bit crazy here, so do a little bit stuff like that. That really looks super cool if you have a bit of a super random distribution of kind of times when this bar is going through your frame. Alright, so this is already looking pretty cool in my opinion. Now you want to replicate this effect on the right hand side. So you want to add some more keyframes here to actually save your full extension of your masks, because obviously you want to have your video being displayed in the middle. And then at the end, which is around 3 seconds here, you want to once again insert some keyframes and then change the right hand value if you want them to move from right to left, such as this, or if you want them to move towards the right, then you can change the left extension to something like that, and this will result in a blend-in of the next scene from the left. Now, something important to note is that I've actually added a second of nothingness at the end here, and this is actually very important because sometimes the stinger transition can lag a little bit if your PC is under a lot of stress, and in these situations it can happen that the entire transition is not gonna show, but it will actually just cut off right about here, and that would then look not very nice. And to prevent this, I've added this kind of second of nothingness at the end. Now, another thing you can do is you can toggle on the transparency layer, and this will help you now to show you how the transition is actually going to look like if you have something different before, and then you're gonna have something different thereafter. Now let's go ahead and change all of these keyframes to some nice values, and then once again go ahead and randomize the start time and the end time of your transition keyframes. Now, important is not to go beneath 3 seconds, but other than that, you can really go crazy here. You can have some super short transitions, and you can have like some super long ones, whatever floats your boat. Now, another thing you want to do is you want to easy out the keyframes at the start, and you want to easy in the ones at the end. That way you're gonna have a bit of a temporal change in the speed of this transition. So this will now actually look really, really cool. And we're gonna do the same for the end keyframes. So once again, easy out for the starting ones and easy in for the ending ones. And as you can see now, you also have a bit of a change in the speed of these bars going through your screen. Now, the last thing we're gonna add before we can actually already render this is we wanna add some blur to this mask, because right now the edges are way too sharp and it just doesn't look very nice to the eye. So go over to Effects, look for Motion Blur, and drag the CC Force Motion Blur on top of your clip. Change the Motion Blur sample to something like 12. The higher you're gonna go here, the slower your render is gonna be, but the nicer these edges are gonna look like. You can use a shutter angle of 360 degrees, so that will make the motion blur effect a bit more into the horizontal direction. And finally, I've added some sound effects to give it a final touch. Now, in order to make sure that this actually works in OBS Studio as a transition element, we need to make sure that the resulting file size is really small. The problem with uncompressed video is that it's basically not really played back smoothly. And what basically happens is it kind of lags like this and then cuts out the transition maybe in the middle. And obviously, we do not want to have that. We want to have it actually playing to the end. And we also want to have the alpha layer in the beginning and in the end. So in order for this to work, we're going to have to install the WebM video codec. And this video codec basically enables you to render in VP9, which is a super small file size format. And it's super compressed and it's pretty much the best you can get out there. So head over to this website. I'm linking it in the description below. Click on download for Mac or download for Windows, depending on the operating system you're on. Run the executable and restart After Effects. Now, once you've installed WebM, click on File, Export, Add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. Wait for a few seconds until this window pops up. Now click on the codec, select WebM, click on Customize. Make sure that the width, height and FPS settings match your project settings. Make sure that VP9 is selected. Use a quality of around 40. Disable two-pass encoding, we don't really need it. And most importantly, make sure that include alpha channel is ticked. If you do not tick this, then all of your transparency layers are not going to be in the final video. Click on OK. Change the file name to whatever you want to. I'm going to call it Stinger. And start the render. Now, this is going to take quite a long time to render. On my system, to render this 2K 60fps 4-second clip, it takes around 50 minutes to 1 hour. So don't worry if this actually takes a lot of your time, you just have to be a bit patient. Alright, it's now about 2 hours later and the render has finally finished. So that means it's about time to show you how to put the Stinger transition into OBS Studio. Don't worry, I'm going to show you how it's done with Streamlabs OBS in just a second. So under Scene Transition, click on the plus icon, hit Stinger, we can just call it Stinger. Browse for the WebM file that you've just rendered. So this is stinger.webm in my case. Choose a transition point, and we'd like to transition at around 1 second into the video, which is where we actually have the entire screen covered by the transition video. Then we want to select the monitor and output as audio monitoring, because we want to hear the transition and we also want to have the transition sound being pushed to Twitch. And finally, select the fade out transition point and then fade it in. So that's already it. Whenever we now go ahead to switch to another scene, we can see that the Stinger is played back together with the sound. All right, now finally I'm going to show you how to implement a Stinger transition with Streamlabs OBS. For that, you want to click on the little cog icon on top of your different scenes. Click on the transition type. Click on Stinger. Now browse for the WebM video once again. Choose 4 seconds. Put again the transition point to 1 second. Click on monitor and output. Click on done. Et voila. As you can see and hear, the Stinger transition is playing as soon as you switch to another scene. And with that, we're already at the end of today's video. I hope you've learned something. If you did, leave a like. If you still have any questions, leave a comment down below. And if you want to see more tutorials such as this one, definitely subscribe. But thanks for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.